are, you are reminded of that. We'll start with the simplest topic of our language, that is nouns. Though I call it the simplest, but only with practice. Otherwise, even this seems difficult. So, nouns, I hope you remember, N for nouns, N for names. This is what I tell my students. N for nouns, N for names. So, all those there, words which are names are nouns. All the words which are names are nouns. The words which we use for naming something, some person, some place are called nouns. Like if I say my name is Ritu. So it's a noun. What's the name of the school? It's Chennar. So it's a noun. What's your name? Suppose your name is Meena. This is a noun. Same time, at the same time. What is Ritu? I'm a lady. Or you can say I'm a teacher. You are using these names. You're using these words to talk about me. These are also nouns. I'll tell you why different. Chennar. What is Chennar? What is Chennar? It's a school. This is again a noun. What is Meena? Meena is a girl. So, ye bhi noun hai. Now, what is the difference? Why Ritu is noun? Lady and teacher also noun. Because whatever I write with capital is called a proper noun. Wherever I name something and I use a capital letter, it is called a proper noun. Wherever I name general, anything, general mein hum baat karte hain, it is not capital S, it's small s. And we don't use a capital, all these are common nouns. All these are common nouns. So, there's a difference between proper noun and common noun. I'm sure you remember. You must not forget. Okay? This you had done very nicely. Class 3, class 4, and it's just a revision. So, proper noun, common noun. Third is your collective noun. Third is your collective noun. What is one line? I know you all know what is collective noun. Collection of things. Like bunch of keys, a bouquet of flowers, a class of students. Dekho, what is this? Bunch, bouquet, class. All these means group. A group of keys is called a bunch. A group of flowers is called a bouquet. A group of students called a class. So, ye collective noun and these are all collective nouns. Now, what we have to remember, one very main important line is, things jo hai, what are forming the groups are with plural. They are being used as plural. We are using S here. But when I made collective noun of it, then it becomes one. Bunch one hai, bouquet one hai, class one hai. So I use a class is attentive. Example hai. I'll say a class is attentive. I am not using it as plural, I'm using it as singular. But what does it mean? Class means many students. Class means many students. So I'll say a class is attending. But at the same time, I can say many students are attending. Agar if I'm using the word many students, then I'll use Now the point is how to use it. Collective noun use karte hain, so we must use it as a singular noun. When we use the word, the common nouns, like jab hum us group ko use kar rahe things, we are talking about things, then we use it as plural and we should use are. Now I said, maine abhi use word kara, singular noun and plural noun. So what is that? You all know very well. What is singular noun and what is plural noun? Whatever we are using as singular, a chair, a table, a boy, ye singular nouns hai. If I say plural nouns, that means when I have made plurals of them, like chairs, like tables, like boys. You all know how to make plurals? So they are called plural nouns. They are called singular nouns and they are called plural nouns. Easier? Now at the same time, let's start differentiating between countable and uncountable. Class 4 में मैंने आपको बताया था, I remember, whether you remember or not, I don't know. But I remember, I had told you what are countable nouns and what are uncountable nouns. Countable nouns, what we can count. Like, I can count how many chairs are there, how many boys are there in the ground, how many girls are sitting, how many rooms in a building, all these can be counted. So these are all countable nouns. Hum kya count nahi kar sakte, whatever we are not able to count, like my hair, like sugar in a jar, like water in a bucket. I cannot count water. I can measure water, but I cannot count. Like oil, like petrol in your car. We don't say how many petrol in the car, we say how much. So when we talk of countable nouns, I must say how many. I must say how many. But when I talk of uncountable nouns, I must say how much. Ye difference will always help you. Keep in mind this difference. When you use countable nouns, you must use the word many. And countables there, use the word much. Okay? So I don't think you have much to do in your nouns chapter because it's only a revision part. We did four kinds of nouns: proper noun, common noun, collective noun. Then we came to singular noun and plural noun. Then we came to countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Easy hai? Now under this you have genders. You have done since class 1, you have been doing genders. Like for a boy, it's a girl. For mother, it's father. For sister, it's bro. For sis, it's bro. Use nahi karna, only for understanding. Now, so these are called gender change. Main thing, countable noun hai aur uncountable noun hai, singular hai ki plural hai, gender male hai ki female hai aur neutral gender hai. Kuch bhi ho, you have to sit and learn. Without learning, it will not be very clear. Initially learn kar lo, then it will get registered here, then you don't need to. So how to learn? You don't have to get up at 5 and learn, mug up nahi karna hai. Read. Repeatedly usko read karenge, then it will get fixed. That will be a better learning. You know, read repeatedly. Read again and again. Now one thing left here, the last thing, abstract noun. Abstract noun. What are abstract nouns? The qualities. You know, something. Like let's say stone hota hai. The stone is very hard. So hard. we can feel, we can understand that King Solomon was very wise, but we cannot touch his wisdom. Touch me kar sakte. So that is abstract now. But if you can touch something, that is called concrete nouns. When you are able to touch the things, that is called concrete nouns. You don't have to bother about anything that you are able to touch is concrete. Anything that you are able to touch is concrete. Table, desktop, marker, board, anything that you are able to touch are concrete nouns. Which you are not able to touch are abstract nouns. Okay. So this again you have to sit at times and read. So basically what we understand is nouns and read. Read repeatedly. Okay. Assignment. Under assignment I'll be sending your worksheet. Means the answers to your workbook exercises. The answers to your workbook exercises I'm sending in the under assignment section in the worksheet. From there you will do. But at the same time you need to understand and then do. Okay. I hope I made myself clear. Now when you read the chapter it will be very clear to you. Bye bye.